Good morning, children. Welcome to Max class. In the last class, we have started our new lesson, lesson 2, factors and multiples. In that, we have studied what are called factors and how we can find factors using multiplication and division method. Today, we are going to study some facts about factors, some of the important points. Okay, first one, all of you look here. 1 is a factor of every number. It is also the smallest factor. Yes. If you can take 2. What are factors of 2? 1 and 2. Factors of 2, we have 1. And 1 is the smallest factor also. Okay. If you are taking any number, we can write that number as a multiple of 1. If it is 55, we can write 1 into 55. So, 1 is a factor and 1 will be the smallest factor. If we are taking 32, we can write 1 into 32. And 1 is a factor, so 1 will be the smallest factor. That is the first point. Second one, the greatest factor of a number is the number itself. Okay, if we are taking factors of 10, the factors are 1, 2, 5, 10. Here, which is the greatest factor? 10, the number itself. Okay, so the greatest factor of a number is the number itself. Next, a factor of a number is always smaller than or equal to the number. Look here, example, factors of 14. 1, 2, 7, 14. Here, 1 is less than 14. 2 is also less than 14. 7 is also less than 14, and here 14, it is equal to 14. So, a factor of a number is always smaller than or equal to the number. And fourth one, as division by 0 is not possible, it is one of the property of division we have already studied in the last lesson. As division by 0 is not possible, so 0 is not a factor of any number. 0 is not a factor of any number. Okay, children. Next point, fifth one. An even number can have both even and odd numbers as factors. Okay. But an odd number can have only odd numbers as factors. Look here, example. Factors of 6. 6 is a 6 is an even number. Even number means it will be multiple of 2. That is 2, 4, 6, 8, all are even numbers. Okay. So, factors of 6 here. Factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3, 6. Here, 2 and 6 both are even numbers. And 1 and 2 are 1 and 3. 1 and 3 are odd numbers. Okay. So, here, factors of 6. 6 is an even number and this 6 has both even and odd numbers as factors. Okay, that is the first point. An even number can have both even and odd numbers as factors. Next, but an odd number can have only odd numbers as factors. Look here, factors of 9. 9 is an odd number, isn't it? So, factors of 9 are 1, 3, 9, only odd numbers. Okay, so an odd number can have only odd numbers as factors. Next point, a number has finite factors, only limited factors. It is the sixth point. Then, seventh one, a factor divides the number exactly. A factor divides the number exactly, leaving no remainder. That we have already studied in the last class. When we divide a number with its factor, by one of its factor, we will get the remainder as 0. That means the number exactly divides. A factor divides the number exactly, leaving no remainder. Next, every number except 1 has at least 2 factors, that is 1 and the number itself. Okay, if you are taking any number, that number except 1, 1 we are not taking. Okay, except 1, if you are taking any number, 1 and that 1 and that number itself will be the factor. That is at least 2 factors will be there. Okay, understood? I hope all of you understood 8 important points. These are the facts about factors. Next, children, we are going to study what are prime and composite numbers. Okay, all of you look here, the number 5. What are the different possible combinations of 5? 5, we can write it as 1 into 5. Any other combination is there? No, only 1 into 5. So, factors of 5, we can write it as 1 and 5. Okay, only 2 factors. Now, look here, 12. What about number 12? 12, we can write it as 1 into 12. Then also 12, we can write as 2 into 6. And also 12, we can write as 3 into 4. So, these are the different possible combinations of 12. Okay, so factors of 12, we can write as 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. Okay, so here, 4, 5, how many factors are there? Only 2 factors. And for here, for 12, how many factors are there? Here, we have 6 factors. So, the numbers which have only 2 factors are called prime numbers. Okay, so here 5 is a prime number. The numbers which have only 2 factors. The 2 factors are 1 and that number itself. Okay, the numbers which have only 2 factors, that is 1 and that number itself, is called prime numbers. And the numbers which have more than 2 factors are called composite numbers. Here, 12 is a composite number. And look here, what about the number 1? Now, 1 is neither prime nor composite, as it is, has only 1 factor. Any other factor is there for 1? No, 1 has only 1 factor, it is 1. So, 1 is neither prime nor composite, as it has only 1 factor. And 1 is a unique number. It is a unique number. Okay, children, understood? Okay, look here, children. Here I have written 2 numbers, 27 and 31. Let's check they are prime or composite. Okay, so first 27. Tell me, what are the different possible combinations of 27? 27, we can write it as 1 into 27. Next, what's the next combination? 2 into any number? No. 3 into any number? Yes. 3 into 9. 3 into 9 is there. Then, 4 into any number? No. 5 into any number? No. 6 into any number? No. So, any other combination is there? No, only these 2 combination, isn't it? Okay, so the factors of 27, we can write factors of 27. They are 1, 3, 9, 27. So, how many factors are there? 4 factors, more than 2 factors are there. So, 27 is a prime number or a composite number? It is a composite number, because here for 27 has more than 2 factors. 4 factors are there. So, 27 is a composite number. Composite number. Okay. Next, what about 31? 31, we can write it as, of course, 1 into 31. 1 into 31. Next, any other combination is there for 31? No other combination. So, only this combination, 1 into 31. So, tell me, children, factors of 31. Factors of 31. 1 and 31, 1 and that number itself, only 2 factors. So, 31 is a prime number. 31 is a prime number. Okay, children, I hope all of you understood today's topic. So, study well for the exam. All the best, children. Thank you.